And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me.
Please stand for the presentation of the bride.
When you already read in my mind, and I don't have a reason. If I don't get to touch your spine, no, I don't need these legs. I ain't walking by your side, and I don't really need to be. If I can't be with you, cause darling, I wake up just to sleep with you.
Who gives this woman to be married?
And I live so I can die with you. Cause darling, I wake up just to sleep with you. I open my eyes so I
maybe see this. Good evening.
Good evening.
God is good, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Amen. My name is Drew Klein. I'm AJ and Tiffany's pastor at South City Church. We want to welcome you all here today to help us celebrate this moment of covenant and commitment between these two lifelong friends. We're assembled here in the presence of God to join AJ and Tiffany in the bond of marriage, which is instituted of God, regulated by his commandments, and has been blessed by our Lord Jesus. Let us then remember that God has crafted and designed marriage for the welfare of mankind and for a reminder representation of the amazing bond between God and his church. The union of marriage should always remind us of the oneness of God with his people. The three of us have met several times over the last several weeks, and I've personally been praying for this day for over 6 months. I wanted us to meet the last few weeks to clearly define God's design and expectation of marriage. What we do today is not just a legal agreement or a time to promise each other the best of intentions, but instead to covenant with a holy God. A covenant is the deepest and most lasting promise someone can make. We do this to love and sacrifice above all things for each other and to trust him for his grace in the process. Till death do they part. Marriage has been described as an instrument of God's sanctifying process in our lives, meaning that when we get married, it's not just to become one, but it's also the hard part of staying one. Somewhere along the road, God uses marriage to make us more like him. And as we serve and forgive and care for each other and cherish one another, he uses our for better and worse to shape us into the image of Jesus. AJ and Tiffany, they're not kids with stars in their eyes. They're adults with life experiences that, by all accounts, make this time of covenant even more understood and authentic. A few years ago, there was a movie that came out, and the star told his female interest, "You complete me." So many of us fall into this trap of thinking that our spouses will complete us and fill all the empty spaces in our lives. And when they don't, we feel all alone and trapped. The reality is that you can never complete each other. You can only complement each other. You can connect with each other. You can care for each other. But know this today, only God can complete you.
All
right. Only God can fully satisfy your heart and fill your soul. Never look to each other for what only God can give you. It's out of that fully satisfying life in Christ that we can appropriately love and serve someone else. AJ and Tiffany, it's my great honor and joy to share this amazing moment with you, my friends, to stand here with you before the Lord in your commitment and covenant to him first and then to each other. I want to read my favorite verse of Scripture having to do with marriage. This is Ephesians 5, 21 through 33. It says this, "Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to yourself to your husbands as you do to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated their own body, but they feed and care for their body just as Christ does his church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I'm talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you must also love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. As we go into this exchange of vows and rings in this time, let's ask the Lord to bless this union today, together today, can we?
Amen.
Father God, thank you for this time. Thank you for this moment. What a privilege to stand before you, before friends and family, to say that you matter most, to say that this covenant is for a lifetime. This covenant is to honor and cherish you first and foremost. And Lord, we stand with this couple. We love them. We bless them. We pray for them. And we believe that you're going to do something special here today for the rest of their lives. And we believe it and pray it in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen.
As you face each other, I ask you these vows. I'll start with you, AJ. Do you, AJ, take Tiffany to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, to honor her, to pour out your life for her, and do all you can to develop her gifts and her abilities for the kingdom, as well as to help her become the woman God wants her to be? Will you keep yourself for her only and promise yourself that no matter how difficult life may be, that next to Christ, she will be your first priority until you leave this earth? Do you, Tiffany, take AJ to be your husband? Do you promise to love him, to honor him, to pour out your life for him, and to do all that you can to help him to become all that he can be as a leader in your home and in his destiny as a leader for God's kingdom? Will you keep yourself for him only and promise that no matter how difficult life may be, that next to Christ, he will be your first priority until you leave this earth? You take the rings. AJ, this ring that you're about to place on Tiffany's finger, I want you to look at it for a minute. It forms a perfect, unbroken circle, as it should. Symbol of your unbroken love for her. Repeat after me as you place this on her finger, please. I, Alvin, take you, Tiffany, to be my wife, my constant friend, and my love from this day forward. In the presence of God, our family and friends, I offer you my solemn vow to be your faithful husband in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad, in joy and in sorrow. I promise to love you, honor and respect you, and to cherish you for as long as we both shall live. Tiffany, this ring that you're about to place on AJ's finger, you'll notice it's made of a precious metal, as it should be, a symbol of the preciousness and purity of your love for him. Repeat after me. I, Tiffany, take you, Alvin, to be my husband, my constant friend, and my love from this day forward, in the presence of God, our family and friends, I offer you my solemn vow to be your faithful wife, in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad, in joy and in sorrow. I promise to love you, honor and respect you, and to cherish you for as long as we both shall live. To symbolize these lives coming together, We're going to symbolize this moment for them coming together. My wife is going to come, and we're going to do what's called a sand ceremony. You know, just like the unity candle, when the sand connects to each other, you can never take it apart again. It will always be a special moment. So the kids, go ahead and come. AJ and Tiffany, go ahead and come over here.
The art of marriage. A good marriage must be created, just like the sand art. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say, I love you at the end of each day. It's never going to bed angry. It's speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It's having the capacity to forgive and forget. It's giving each other a safe place in which to grow. It's not only marrying the right person, it's being the right partner. Our marriage prayer for this beautiful family, pray with us. Lord, in your providence, you have provided the family as a place where people can experience love, learn important life lessons, and find unequaled encouragement. May your design be reflected in this new family. I pray that you would unite and bind this family together. Even in togetherness, may there be space to be individuals. Help each person to love, respect, and encourage others within the family. May the care and hospitality within the family be extended to those outside, that others might see your presence. Bind these hearts and lives together as a beautiful work of art. In Jesus' name, and all God's people say, amen. Amen.
Waiting for this moment. This is a good moment. God is good.
Yes, he is.
I want to remind you of something I said a little bit earlier as your friend and pastor. Marriage is a beautiful moment. When moments like these fade, and days of incredible love, like I mentioned before, they fade. The thing that holds us together is not our feelings, it's not romance, it's not a moment, it's a person. His name is Jesus.
Yes.
He's the only way that a marriage will make it. Lean into him. Lean into him. This beautiful unity that he gives us today in this covenant, this marriage covenant, is one that will sanctify you as believers and draw you closer to Jesus if you'll allow it. By the authority given to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I declare that AJ and Tiffany are now husband and wife according to